Hello, and welcome once again to another broadcast of Grass is Blue here on AROUSE OSU Student Radio. I'm Ella Cope, and today we'll be celebrating all things femme with an all-female show. Nothing fancy, just a good sit-down listen to some of my favorite female bluegrass country and folk voices. I'd like to start with perhaps my favorite bluegrass song, The Wagoner's Lad, sung by the Cossoy Sisters. One time my dad and I were listening to this old bluegrass song, and he remarked about how he always wondered who wrote it, who sat down in their kitchen and wrote it. So many songs in the bluegrass tradition were passed down by word of mouth, and many have roots as far back as the medieval era, meaning that we don't know who wrote them and won't ever know. This is that song for me. I will always wonder who wrote it and what that woman was like. Who was the Wagoner's Lad? And who was she? Enjoy.
Of all women, to help me take my life less seriously. It's only life after all. Yeah. Well, darkness has a hunger that's insatiable. And lightness has a call that's hard to hear. And I wrap my fear around me like a blanket. I sail my ship of safety till I sank it. I'm crawling on your shores. I went to the doctor. I went to the mountains. I looked to the children. I drank from the fountains. There's more than one answer to these questions, pointing me in a crooked line. And the less I seek my source for some definitive, closer I am to find.
We've been hearing songs by new songs by other people. Now we're going to meet one of the people who sings her own songs, and she's very, very ornamental, I can tell you right now. Name's Joni Mitchell. She's from Saskatoon. She's going to sing for you "Night in the City," her own song.
Light up, light up, light up your lazy blue eyes. Moon's up, night's up, taking the town by surprise. Nighttime, nighttime, they left an hour ago. City light time, must you get ready so slow? There are places to come from and places to go. Night in the city looks pretty to me. Night in the city looks fine. Music comes spilling out into the street. Colors go flashing in time. take off your stay-at-home shoes. Break off, shake off, chase off those stay-at-home blues. Stairway, stairway, down to the crowds in the street. They go their way, looking for faces to greet, but we run on laughing with no one to meet. Night in the city looks pretty to me. Night in the city looks fine. Music comes spilling out into the street. Colors go waltzing in time.
That was, of course, Joni Mitchell with Night in the City, and before that was the Indigo Girls with Closer to Fine. As many of you may know, Joni has been in the news recently for her decision to remove her discography from Spotify over concerns about the platform's publishing of vaccine disinformation, specifically on the Joe Rogan podcast. Joni herself is a polio survivor, and her announcement, I think, has a lot of people reevaluating Spotify and music streaming altogether. To reflect on that, I'd like to play a song off of Gillian Welch's first independently released album, Time the Revelator, which addresses the complexities of streaming and online music services directly. Here's Everything is Free.
Everything is free now, that's what they say. Everything I ever done, gonna give it away. Someone hit the big score, they figured it out that we're gonna do. Every day I wake up, I'm in a song. But I don't need to run around. I just stay home and sing a little love song. My love and myself. If there's something that you wanna hear, can sing it yourself, 'cause everything is free now. That's what I said. No one's gotta listen to the words in my head. Someone hit the big score. I figured it out, and I'm gonna do it anyway, even if it doesn't pay.
That old photograph of ours sure looks out of place. Laying on your bag out in the hall. You're taking it to remind you of our better days. The ones you say you'll miss when you're gone. Don't lie. Don't lie, you owe weary blues from waiting. Lord, I've been waiting so long. These blues have got me crying. Oh, sweet mama, won't you please come home? The snow falls down my window, but it can't chill my heart. God knows that it died the day you left my dream. Fell apart. Weary blues from waiting. And Lord, I've been waiting so long. These blues have got me crying. Oh, sweet mama, won't you please come home? Through tears I watch young lovers as they go strolling by. Oh, God forgive me if I cry. Oh, weary blues from waiting, Lord, I've been waiting so long, at me crying. Oh, sweet mama, won't you please come home? Oh, sweet mama, won't you please come home. That
was the Waylon Jennies with Weary Blues from Waitin'. And before that was Don't Lie by the incredible Rhonda Vincent. You are listening to Grass is Blue on AROUSE OSU Student Radio. Next up, here's Emmylou Harris.
Me and my best friend Lillian and her blue tick hound dog Gideon, sitting on the front porch, cooling in the shade, singing every song the radio played, waiting for the Alabama sun to go down to a red dirt girls in a red dirt town. Me and Lillian, just across the line and a little southeast of Marin. Somewhere alive.
she learned to bend. One thing they don't tell you about the blues when you got them, keep on falling, cause there ain't no bottom, there ain't no end. At least not for the living. Nobody knows when she started her skit. She was only 27 and she had 5 kids. Could have been the whiskey, could have been the pills, could have been the dream she was trying to kill. But there won't be a mention in the news of the world about the life and the death of a red dirt girl named Lillian. Who never got any further across the line of Meridian.
You'll be forever on my mind.
question.
That was Yola with Whatever You Want. And before that was the incomparable, the singular, Bonnie Raitt with You, with backup vocals from Alison Krauss. Something I'm really interested in when we talk about women in country music is what's known as the other woman's song. In the days of classic country, other woman's songs were just that, songs by female artists written to the woman that their husband was having an affair with. These songs were usually insulting and sometimes threatened physical violence against the other woman. Think about Loretta Lynn telling the other woman that she'll take her to Fist City and lift her by the hair of the head and throw her in a garbage can. While these songs may seem regressive at first, we have to understand that female musicians like Loretta were operating in a highly misogynistic music industry, and these other women's songs were what sold, so of course they wrote them. And the reason they sold is because they upheld sexist systems which pitted women against each other in service of men. Let's listen to a classic example by Loretta herself.
Take my man. Women like you, there are a dime a dozen. You can buy 'em anywhere. For you to get to him, I'd have to move over, and I'm gonna stand right here. It'll be over my dead body, so get out while you can. 'Cause you ain't woman enough to take my man. He's in love with me. Well, I don't know where that leaves you. Oh, but I know where I stand. And you ain't woman enough to take my man. Women like you, there are a dime a dozen. You can buy 'em anywhere. For you to get to him, I'd have to move over, and I'm gonna stand right here. Take my man.
got your class ring. That proved you care. And it still looks the same as when you gave it, dear. The only thing different, the only thing new, I've got these little things, she's got you. I've got your memory, or has it got me? Your class ring that proved you cared, and it still looks the same as when you gave it, dear. The only thing different, the only thing new, I've got these little things, she's got.
That was She's Got You by Patsy Cline, which I would argue is equal parts breakup song and other woman song. Now, if you've been listening to this show for a while, you might have noticed that I haven't yet played a song very near and dear to my heart. Well, I've been saving it for this, because you see, what makes this song so special is that it was the first song to subvert the other woman trope. The singer is speaking to the other woman, but she's pleading, not threatening. What makes this song so important is that it reveals the artificiality of the woman versus woman conflict, instead emphasizing compassion and mutual respect. Here is Jolene.
Jolene, 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 Jolene. Of auburn hair with ivory skin and eyes of emerald green. Your smile is like a breath of spring, your voice is soft like summer rain, and I cannot compete with you, Jolene. He talks about you in his sleep, and there's nothing I can do to keep from crying when he calls your name, Jolene. Understand how you could easily take my man, but you don't know what he means to me, Jolene. Jolene, 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 I'm begging of you, please don't take my man. Jolene, 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 please don't take him just because you. Of men, but I could never love again. He's the only one for me, Jolene. I had to have this talk with you. My happiness depends on you and whatever you decide to do, Jolene.
Even though you can, Jolene,
Well, folks, that's all the time we have today on Grass is Blue. As always, thank you for hanging out with me this morning, and I hope you've enjoyed my selections during this Femme Forward hour. I'm Ella Cope, and I'll leave you with a reflection on representation and politics from one of the matriarchs of modern banjo, Ola Belle Reed, followed by her song, Fortunes.
I know you have strong feelings about politics and people and how the government is and how the world is just in general among themselves, people among people.
That is right. I positively do. It's a terrible thing to say, but I've been in business. I have played music. I've been in with people, in and around people continuously for 40 years. And it is a terrible thing to say, but really and truly, the average everyday person like me, I'm not being pitiful and I don't want any sympathy from anybody. I'm not saying it for that reason. But I am saying that we have such a small bit of representation, and I have papers and letters to prove it, because you are told to get in touch with your local authorities. If you want to find out something, then you get in touch with your state authorities, your state government, and in with your federal government. And my letters always come back from the secretary or somebody saying, we were glad to get your letter, and I know you realize that the governor is a very, very busy man, and if there's any way that we could assist you, you know, you don't get there. And I think that is exactly why that we've had problems of people that have gone too far. They can't be heard, so therefore they throw a rock.
Like a tiny little snowflake slowly floating from the sky. Oh, there are wonders never ceasing, created by our master's hand. But the greatest of all our fortunes is in God's promised land. Oh, the rich man with all of his money, all his silver and all his gold. Oh, he can't buy one breath of life or a home for his weary soul. For bought and it is paid for by the blood of the blessed land. But the greatest of all our fortunes is in God's promised land. Teardrop Oh, there are fortunes in a smile, in the face of a weary pilgrim, or the face of a little child. Oh, there are fortunes in your Bible. If you'll read it, you'll understand. But the greatest of all our fortunes is in God's promised land. Oh, the rich man with all of his money, all his silver and all his gold, he can't buy one breath of life or a home for his weary soul. For it is bought and it is paid for by the blood of the blessed Lamb. But the greatest of all our fortunes is in God's promise.